Hey Kanasnips and mga ka-pageant funnies! Welcome back to our channel! I am your Nasnip Daryl and for today's video, samahan nyo akong mag-anticipate ng potential outcome ng Binibining Pilipinas 2021 dahil hindi lingid sa ating mga kaalaman na after almost 2 long years, I finally, mangyayari na or kaunting kembot o tulog na lang patungo sa Grand Coronation Night, which shall happen on July 11th, Sunday, 9:30 p.m. And I am sure that by now, sobrang kinikiliti na ang ating mga isipan sa kung sino kayang mga binibini out of the official 34 binibinis ang makakapasok sa cut na top 12 or top 13 sa semis at eventually ay makokoronahan ng kanya-kanyang titles. Lalo na na-witness na natin sila sa kanya-kanyang presentation ng national costume, ng swimwear, kung saan ipakita nila ang kanilang pageant physique and pasarela, and lastly, BBP primer kung saan sila sumagot ng questions at paano nila na-demonstrate ang grace under pressure. So if you wanna see more of this video, just keep on watching! Before I proceed on sharing with you guys ang aking binibini standouts o ang mga binibini na sa tingin ko ay may malaking chance na makapasok sa semis, i-accommodate muna natin ang request ng ating kapamilya sa TikTok na si Samuel Rentino, kung saan sinabi niya na ni, if may time ka, gawa ka ng top 10 mo sa best free speech sa Binibini Pilipinas. For I share with you my top favorite performers on Binibining Pilipinas Primer, I would want to let you know that I had these three personal criteria for judging the Binibini's performance. Number one is the confidence or the grace under pressure. Kung saan gustong gusto ko yung sinabi ni Tito Boy about confidence, na ang confidence ay hindi sa pagbibigay ng right answer. But it is more of the absence of doubt or pagiging sure sa sinasabi mo that would eventually impact or affect the listener. Number two, I was also looking into the content of the answer kung saan the binibinis beforehand were provided this photo and were expected to relate these photos to themselves or their personal experiences plus at the same time to give a message of hope to the listener. And lastly, I was looking at the smoothness of delivery. Ito na nga ang aking top 10 favorite performers sa Primer. Maureen Montaigne.
In this image, we see a man getting vaccinated and our healthcare workers. And I think this is a beautiful image. This is a powerful, relevant image to our time. I myself was fully vaccinated here in QC, and I think it's one of those key steps to healing and to overcoming COVID. And I encourage everyone to keep practicing our safety protocols, to get vaccinated, to reach out to your local barangay, to your city, and to reach out and fully use your resources, because together we can defeat this virus.
Rachella Liman.
What I can see from the picture is a jitney, as well as passengers with plastic dividers. And one of the most affected sectors here during the pandemic are our local drivers, as well as the commuters. And it is truly saddening that no matter how we fight it, it has taken a heavy toll on them. And this is a clear example of a simple effort from a small sector. And this is something that we should emulate. Together, let's do our part. And if we collectively come together as a community, we can achieve herd immunity. Thank you.
Justine Felizarita.
I do feel quite sad because this is not the normal way of giving birth to a child. But because of the uncertainties that this pandemic has given us, I am appreciative of our professional healthcare workers who have stepped up and had the courage to do this for people who don't have the luxury to go to hospitals. And I myself have family members who are struggling to just get into hospital. And if there was a person like this to approach us, I would be eternally grateful. And in this pandemic, I always thought we could either spread fear or be the light that everyone wants to see. And this is exactly what I'm seeing here. Thank you.
What I see in this picture is actually my cousin. During this pandemic, I've spent a lot of time with my cousin, and she has 3 kids. So I actually help giving them education because it's so hard to teach with 3 kids, especially that they're all young, they're all toddlers. So I appreciate the efforts of moms, especially single moms during this pandemic. And I just want to say that even during these times, we should never give up on our dreams, especially for our children. Thank you.
Samantha Panlilio.
Looking at this photo, it reminds me that we need to fix Mother Nature, and we have to be more aware about pollution nowadays. During the pandemic, I was able to take a step back and realize that we actually live in a community where we don't really practice a lot of sustainable ways. And this is actually my advocacy as well. And this is something that I definitely want to focus on so that people can make more and take more initiative towards making this earth a sustainable world. Thank you.
Bianca Marcelo.
What I see on the screen is a community pantry, and I also did this during the quarantine. And it is very close to my heart because this is also my advocacy, because I am really passionate about inequality. I feel the gap between the privileged and underprivileged. That is the main reason why I advocate for hunger problems, because I believe that no man can be wise on an empty stomach. Thank you.
Noriza Valerio.
This picture represents myself during the ECQ. I've used my time to improve more of myself and also to know more of my imperfections. And I believe that as persons, it is normal that we are not perfect. That is a fact of life. And during this pandemic, it may put the world on halt, but it reminded us that things do not end here and that there are more things to look forward to.
Charina Diao.
COVID-19 really made us life uneasy. And what I can see on the photo is online shopping. I myself is an online shopping warrior, but then let us all remember to those online shoppers just like me, that in this time of crisis, we must only buy what we need, because money is very important in this time of crisis. We should use them wisely. And I just also want to leave a message that in these times, this is just a test of our spirit and characteristics as well. So let us all be patient until the world comes into its normal state once again.
Gabriel Basciano.
This photo shows a new family, a happy family actually. During this time of pandemic, it was really hard for us to reconnect with our family and even to find a partner, because we were just inside our house. But this photo gives us hope that we can always welcome new beginnings in our life, and that this pandemic is just a test of real faith and determination. And we should always have patience with us. We should just cooperate for this pandemic to end. And of course, lastly, to have a strong faith, because I know that we will win this battle together.
Karina Carino.
Seeing this photo makes me excited because it gives us that sense of normalcy. It's something that is important to me as well. Being an avid fan of K-pop and even P-pop, I really appreciate seeing online events still boom during this pandemic. I hope that this serves as a reminder for us that things are never canceled. We can still continue to enjoy life while we are in the crisis.
Special mention to Graciela Liman. I love how composed she was while answering the question. And you can see on her face that she was in control of herself. Also, to Maureen Montaigne. With her BBP primer performance, Maureen has solidified herself for a rightful spot, or for a rightful title. She, for me, is the one to be. And lastly, Justine Felizarta, I commend how she was able to tickle my emotions with her delivery. Nalaliman ako doon sa hugot niya doon sa photo. So for me, the top 3 performers out of the top 10 that I chose are Maureen Munting, Graciela Lima, and Justine Felizarta. At bago tayo tuluyang tumungo sa aking personal top 13 Binibini standouts, ay kung gusto niyo po itong video na to, please give it a thumbs up and also consider subscribing to our channel and set your notification bell to all so that you will be notified of all the future videos. And this is it! My top 13 Binibini standouts. My 13th slot is Binibini Cagayan de Oro, Cindy Faye Obenita. Cindy Faye Obenita has everything that it takes to deserve a title or a placement, at least in the runners-up. Cindy, for me, has this grace and elegance. She's stunning and intelligent. In terms of communication skills, we can count on her, considering that she has been hosting pageants and events, and she's a graduate of mass communication. And also, kasama siya sa top 10 best in national costume. Cindy Faye Obenita too ay patok na patok sa voters sa JAG, Manila Bulletin, and other platforms. Kaya maaaring sabihin natin na malaki talaga ang chance ni Cindy Faye na makapasok sa semi. On my 12th slot is Binibini Bulacan, Bianca Marcelo. Si Bianca Marcelo ay hindi na baguhan sa national pageant, considering that she has already joined Miss World 2015. At nagpakitang gila si Bianca Marcelo sa talent segment ng Binibining Pilipinas, kung saan siya nagpamalas ng kamanghamanghang magic tricks na talaga naman pumatok sa mga manonood. And isa rin si Bianca Marcelo sa napili ng top 10 best in national costume. At hindi niya rin tayo mineno sa kanyang performance sa preliminary swimsuit competition at sa primer. On my 11th spot is Binibining La Union, Karina Carino. Hindi na siya baguhan sa national pageant, considering how she bagged the first runner-up Miss Millennial Philippines 2017 on Itbulaga. Karina is gorgeous and elegant, and she is known for her strong polarizing opinions, lalo na sa inclusivity and diversity, kung saan sinabi niya na ang definition of a woman these days ay hindi na lamang para sa mga naturally born women, but will also include people who identify themselves as women. My 10th placer goes to my kababayan, Binibining Cavite, Samantha Panlilio. Si Samantha Panlilio ay isang go-getter, at alam niya at authentic siya sa kung ano ang gusto niya ipaglaban na advocacy, which is sustainability. At na-witness din natin yon sa answer niya sa primer. And yun yung alas niya, na sure siya sa kung ano ang gusto niyang ipaglaban. Also, she is rumored to be one of the favorites of Angkol Nawat sa Miss Grand International title, kahit na ang preferred title ni Samantha ay intercontinental, being a huge fan of Karen Gallman. She is eloquent and smart. At siya lamang naman ang chief marketing officer ng hotels and resorts na pagmamay-ari ng sarili niyang pamilya. Kaya masasabi natin na may makinarya at resources talaga si Samantha Panlilio. And lastly, Samantha Panlilio comes from the bloodline of beauty queens, lalong-lalo na ang kanyang auntie na si Mirna Panlilio ang kauna-unahan lamang naman na binibining Pilipinas here. My ninth placer is binibining Iloilo, Karen Lori Mendoza. She might be a newbie to national pageant, pero hindi talaga natin ma-deny ang presence ni Karen Mendoza, lalo na sa lahat ng materials na nire-release niya. At nagpapasiklab din naman talaga si Karen Mendoza sa lahat ng mga nakaraang presentation. National costume, hindi man siya nakasama sa top 10, best in national costume ay talagang nagpasiklab pa rin siya sa preliminary swimsuit competition and lalong-lalo na sa Q&A niya sa BB Primer. Hindi rin natin pwedeng baliwalain ang achievement niya sa Supermodel Philippines 2019. On my 8th spot, is binibining Summer, Gabriel Basiano. Si Gabriel ang may pinaka-versatile na face kung saan pwede siyang makakuha ng kahit na anong title. Dahil sa versatile face niya, sa height niya, at sa talaga naman ding mga accomplishments niya sa pageantry. Being placed in the top 15 of Miss Earth 2018, and at the same time, she's the first runner-up sa Miss Friendship International. I am having some apprehensions sa kanyang communication skills, pero nakita natin sa BB Primer na kayang-kaya niyang bigyan ng hustisya ang Q&A portion ng pageant. At sa strong Eurasian features niya, feeling ko papatok siya sa Intercon. At isa din naman siya sa mga paboritong-paborito ni Uncle Nawat for Miss Grand International. On my 7th spot is binibining Valenzuela, Meiji Cruz. Para sa akin, si Meiji Cruz ang best performer ng preliminary swimsuit competition na kung saan talaga niya naman napakita na handang-handa siyang rumampa para sa Miss Grand International. Also, si Meiji Cruz ay returnee from Binibining Pilipinas 2012 kung saan ang naging Binibining Pilipinas Universe ay si Janine Togonon. Kabatch niya pa sina MJ Lastimosa, Karen Gallman, Katrina Dimaranan at Ali Forbes. Tingnan natin kung gaano kahanda this time si Meiji Cruz magpasiklab para ma-deserve niya ang isang title ng Binibining Pilipinas. On my top 6 is a sentimental favorite of mine, Binibini Oriental Mindoro, Graciela Liman, na talaga namang nagpakitang gilas din sa preliminary swimsuit competition at lalong-lalo na sa Q&A niya sa Primer. At hindi maide-deny ang kagandahang taglay ni Graciela Liman, being a Filipina sweet German beauty. Ang ganda ng eyes, ang ganda ng smile, ang ganda ng grace, composure, and confidence sa sarili niya, considering that she is a newbie to national pageant. On my 5th spot is no other than the towering height, porcelain doll-like beauty hailing from Canberra, Australia, or si Binibining Masbate, Hannah Arnold. Pagdating sa tangkad at sa gandang manikaan, uwian na kay Hannah Arnold. A professional model and also the charity queen of 2014, kung saan 18 years old pa lamang siya ay sumali na siya sa Miss Philippines Australia and Charity Queen para mangalap ng funds para sa kanyang charity event or advocacy. Si Hannah Arnold din ay returnee from Binibining Pilipinas 2019 kung saan nakasama siya sa top 15, however, she wasn't able to snatch a crown. Pero hindi maide-deny ang presence ngayon ni Hannah Arnold sa ganda niya na pinaghalong side ng nanay niya na Filipina at side ng dad niya na Irish-Austrian ay talaga namang malakas ang laban para sa isang corona. Maaaring Miss International. My fourth placer is binibining Davao del Sur, Justine Felizarta. The epitome of gandang Pinay, intelligence, and sophistication. Justine is a returnee from Binibining Pilipinas 2015 kung saan nakasama siya ng top 15. However, during that time, she wasn't able to snatch a crown at ang nanalo na Binibining Pilipinas Universe that time ay si Pia Wurtzbach. At nakakuha din siya ng top 10 placement sa Miss Universe Canada 2017. At ngayon, sa performances niya sa preliminary swimsuit competition at primer, walang duda, pasok si Justine Felizarta. Ang napaka-memorable pa kay Justine Felizarta ay nung rumampa siya ng may katangi-tanging design ng swimsuit nung preliminary swimsuit competition ng Binibining Pilipinas dahil kakagaling niya lang sa isang medical surgery. Pero hindi siya nagpaawat sa pagrampa. My third placer is an independent candidate, Binibini Rizal, Honey Chris Cartasalo. We could notice her big improvement from the prior times she joined the national pageant. First was in Mutianang Pilipinas 2018, where she placed in the top 25, and the second was Binibining Pilipinas 2019, kabatch ni Gazini Ganados, kung saan hindi siya nakakuha ng placement. Pero kitang-kita natin ang naging improvement niya under the training of no other than the Barkad's Paolo Ballesteros. Napakaganda ng aura ni Honey Cartasalo lately, lalo na sa mga marketing articles or materials na nire-release niya sa kanyang social media platforms. Kailangan ni Honey Grace mag-improve pa sa kanyang communication skills at confidence. But overall, I think she already deserves an international title. And now for my second spot is no other than Binibining Angeles Pampanga Francesca Taruk, na talaga namang patok na patok sa pageant fans ang napakagandang aura na manyikaan ni Francesca. At ilang beses na rin namang napatunayan ni Francesca ang sarili niya sa national pageants noon, having snatched the title of Miss Freedom of the World Philippines 2018 at Miss Tourism World Intercontinental 2019, na kung saan lamang naman hinakot niya ang awards na Best in Body, Miss Swimwear, Best in Evening Gown at kung ano-ano pa. Napakalakas din ang laban ni Francesca for the international title ng Binibining Pilipinas. At humantong na tayo sa aking the one to beat, Binibini Batangas Maureen Monsing. Maureen is a veteran of national pageant, having proven herself on Mutianang Pilipinas 2013, Miss USA Arizona 2015, at isinabak siya for the Miss USA 2015 na kung saan lamang naman nakatunggali niya si Olivia Jordan, ang representative ng USA sa Miss Universe na nakalaban naman ang ating Miss Universe Pia Wurtzbach. Sumabak na rin si Maureen sa Miss World USA 2017 and Miss World Philippines 2018 kung saan nakuha ni Maureen ang Miss Eco Philippines at isinabak siya for Miss Eco International at nagkamit ng first runner-up finish. Nang ma-dethrone ang title holder ng Eco International nung time ni Maureen, si Maureen dapat ang mag-a-assume ng throne and magtitake ng responsibilities and duties. However, she wanted to compete for Binibining Pilipinas 2020 at inabot na nga tayo ngayon ng 2021, kaya nandito si Maureen. And considering that her age is not anymore qualifying for Grand International and Intercontinental, dalawa na lang ang titles na pwede kay Maureen. And Maureen has obviously rebranded herself for Miss International. At magbe-birthday din si Maureen sa July 10th, at day before the Grand Coronation Night, so baka naman, napakagandang birthday gift for Maureen ang pagkakapanalo ng Binibini Pilipinas International title. At katulad ng sinabi ko at the start of this video that we will be anticipating the potential outcome of Binibini Pilipinas 2021 Grand Coronation Night, here it is. Second runner-up, might be Meiji Cruz. First runner-up might be Hannah Arnold. Binibini Pilipinas Globe might be Justine Felizarta. Binibini Pilipinas Intercontinental might be Gabriel Basciano. Binibini Pilipinas Grand International might be Honey Cartasano. And Binibini Pilipinas International might be Maureen Montaigne. Mga ka-pageant fanes, don't forget to take everything I say here with a grain of salt. Dahil hindi po tayo si Madam Stella at hindi rin po tayo ang judges ng Grand Coronation Night. So sama-sama na lang talaga nating abangan kung sino talaga ang makakakuha ng mga corona at runner-up finish sa Grand Coronation Night. I-enjoy lang natin. So there you have it. My top 13 Binibini Pilipinas 2021 standouts. Sino ang standouts para sa inyo? Please do not hesitate to comment below kung ano yung thoughts nyo about this video at kung sino-sino ang mga standouts sa inyo na wala sa listahan ko. And before I forget, Binibini Pilipinas has this Voter's Choice Award na kung sino daw ang binibini na magkakamit nito ay magkakaroon ng secured placement sa semifinals. So, don't miss the opportunity to vote for your favorite binibini para ma-secure ang slot nila at makita pa natin sila sa evening gown, swimsuit at Q&A. And mga kanasibs and ka-pageant fanies, please, if you like this video, consider giving it a thumbs up and also subscribing to our channel. Set your notification bell to all so that you will be notified of all our future videos. Dahil after ng Grand Coronation Night ng Binibining Pilipinas, ay magsasama-sama pa tayo sa ibang pageants like Miss Universe Philippines. And thank you for watching this video. And see you on our next video! Yeah!